My name is Grace, and today I will be talking about Phyllis Wheatley. Who is Phyllis Wheatley? Why does she stand out from other people of her time? Well, Phyllis Wheatley was born in Africa, but at age 7, she was kidnapped and sold as a slave in Massachusetts. She was weak, frail, homesick, and she didn't know anything about English or the language that those white people were speaking. But she was bought as a private slave for the Wheatley family, who were very kind to her. Miss Wheatley's daughter, Mary, was a few years older than Phyllis, and she taught Phyllis to read English and Latin, and also to write English. Phyllis still had to keep up her duties as a slave, but she was relentlessly studious and wrote her first poem around the age of 15 on the subject of the Stamp Act being repealed. Her poem went like this. Your subjects hope, dread sire, the crown upon your black brows may flourish long, and that your arm may in your God be strong. O may your scepter numerous nations sway, and all with love and readiness obey. But how shall we British king reward? Rule thou in peace, our father and our lord. Midst the remembrance of thy favors past, the meanest peasants most admire thy last, and may each clime with equal gladness see, a monarch's smile can set his subjects free. When Miss and Mr. Wheatley discovered her poem, they sent it to the Sons of Liberty, the government at the time, to see what they thought, because they were not sure Phyllis actually had the capacity to write so well. After quizzing her and asking for meanings to the lines of the poems, they were sure Phyllis was a wonderful writer. You have a great gift, Samuel Adams told her. Samuel Adams was a cousin of John Adams. And it must be used, he finished. Phyllis wrote many poems, but it was difficult to find a willing publisher because at that time no one wanted to publish something by a black person. This was utter racism, but Phyllis, with the help of Miss Wheatley, found somebody to publish her first poem book. Archibald Bell published Phyllis Wheatley's first book of poems, entitled Poems on Different Subjects, Religion, and Morale. She was thought of for a short time as among the best 19th century poets, but she earned little money from the books because she gave most to the Wheatleys, because Miss Wheatley became ill. After Miss Wheatley's death, Phyllis was freed, and she later married another freed slave. She wrote at least hundreds more poems, but around 30 were lost and never found, and she died in 1784, about 9 years after the Revolutionary War started, because she was in poverty, as there was nobody to publish her poems. In conclusion, Phyllis has and will continue to inspire many with her writing skills, and she paved a path for black people and women after her. Thank you for listening.
Life from NASA Ames Center at Mountain View, California.